Well, how's that for a flub up? Hey guys, welcome to the stream. I am the professional artist. Happy Halloween or Happy October, everybody. Happy Inktober, and glad to see you made it in for a little bit. Let's see here, fix that. Is everything working good? Everybody hear me? Can't tell. Nobody's saying anything in the chat. Well, anyway, gonna do a little bit of some warm ups here. I don't. Haven't exactly been in practice for a couple of days, so we'll just do some basic warm-ups, and then I'll do a main drawing probably here towards the end of the stream. Completely bored out of your minds. What's everybody up to today? Thank you. person that's on here. Thanks for stopping in anyway. I guess I could try explaining a little bit of what I do. Most part, it's just some basic construction. Start off with shapes and circles and like, usually cones, spheres, cylinders, just basics. Big scowl. He's angry. Not the Hulk, but he's definitely not happy. Maybe he's the Punisher. Who knows? Yeah. He's Frank Castle. Just to indicate who he is. funny enough, is actually where the whole skull on those t-shirts things originates from. It's from the Punisher. This one here, we could even say is just a female figure. Add some arms. Very generic pose. Couple on knees. Add some thighs. There's her calves. Give me an idea of where the breasts will go. And in true comic book fashion, the breasts are always pretty large. And this one here, we could just say it's part of the arm, so we can make it a bicep. Yeah. Block it out. There's the tri. Part of the tricep. And then slide on down into the elbow and the forearm. And up here we'll have for the shoulder muscle. And I'm just doing little doodles and such. Just like I said, I'm just trying to warm up. Nothing too fancy. Being done without some construction, just all to help keep me warm or get me warmed up and loose. And this is actually going to be an Inktober drawing as well, what I have in mind. I normally don't usually use the prompts, but for this particular one, it just seems kind of fun. Since it was fish, my first thought was going to be Aquaman or the Submariner. They're both comic book characters. Aquaman is owned by DC and Mariner is owned by Marvel. around here. I'm just doing some eyes now, some noses. Just some basic stuff, just trying to get everything to stop creaking. Excuse me. Give you anime. So to the one person on here, you just being quiet or you just enjoying the art? What's going on? How are you? Okay, I think I've got myself sufficiently warmed up now. We'll start the main drawing. Okay, so the Inktober prompt was... So the Inktober prompt for this month, or this week, or today, was fish. And... I'm more of a monster buff when it comes to that kind of thing. I had initially intended to just use a original character of mine that I drew years ago. go a different route. If we want a monstrous fish, we want to see something scary. It's Halloween. So let's draw something that'll terrify somebody.
Get your big head out of the way so you can see.
One thing I always do is I always start off with a basic construction just to get a feel for where I want this pose to go. And it might take me several tries before I'm happy with the pose. Might not. Trying to decide if I want it to be a humanoid or if I want to go full fish. Thinking humanoid. Let's face it, while fish are scary and I can certainly do them that way, what's more terrifying than something like what you'd see from a 1950s movie done up by somebody that makes monsters? Big smile at the jagged teeth. Because a fish isn't gonna have a dentist. His teeth ain't gonna look straight and clean. They're gonna be jutting all over the place. Real vicious looking. Because he's humanoid, he's gonna have something like a chin. Now, on a normal person, the eyes are usually focused around the center of the face, and then you add your things there. In this case, since he's a fish man, his eyes are gonna be off to the side of his head. Which I think is really gonna hopefully add to the aesthetic. Make him look uncanny valley. We want him to look something horrifying. We don't want him to just be typical fish creature. Now we want him to look like something that would come straight out of somebody's nightmare. Big hulking creature. Rows of jagged teeth and claws. Now to be fair though, fish don't really have claws. But then again. Now. The one thing I think I'm might do is I might leave him pupilless because, let's face it, if it has pupils, it doesn't seem to be as terrifying. We'll see. Get in torso here. hulking behemoth of a creature. Maybe he's a mutated whale or a anglerfish. Them suckers are pretty scary in and of themselves. Yeah, maybe he's an anglerfish. So we're gonna need that little antenna thing that they have on top of their head. Like that. I don't know about that. That kind of makes him look a little goofy. We'll see. Might like it later. Once I get into detail work. Right now it's just all about feeling things out. Nice thing about drawing monsters is nobody can tell you that it looks wrong. Because if they say, well, this isn't how this monster should look, you can look at him and say, well, have you ever seen one in real life? And the answer will always be, well, no. Because these such things don't exist. I'll be honest though, I didn't make up that one. That one I stole from a comic book artist by the name of Todd McFarlane. Great artist. The chance to, I highly recommend looking up some of his work. I take some inspiration from him when it comes to doing monsters and the like. Musculature, just kind of still filling things out, see what I like, see what I don't. About the tail. Just leave him with 3 fingers per hand. Well, 4 if you count the thumb. Old joke. Hold up. Hold up 3 fingers. How many fingers am I holding up? You're holding up 3. No, dumbass. It's 2 fingers and a thumb. at him, the more I'm starting to like him. This is still something I'm curious about. Not sure if I'm keeping the antenna. Still on the fence about this tail. I don't know if I'm gonna keep it or not. Shnikes. Like I said, this is the nice thing about monsters. There's no wrong way to draw. It's all in what you want. getting somewhere. Oh, hello. Not sure who just subscribed, but thank you. I think what I might do is might add a couple of fins. I'm not positive yet. Fins make the man. The Inhuman. Don't really have eyes. Well, they do, but don't have pupils. And since this is supposed to be a mutated anglerfish, thinking our character's not gonna have pupils either. I thinking he might, just might. Only have eyes of white. And I think in the big mouth. Change the teeth out a little. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. Now. Oh, I do have three people in here. This thing needs changed up one of these days. I gotta fix that. Hello, hello, and welcome to the other person that's on here now. I'm the unprofessional artist. Hope you're enjoying the stream so far. Feel free to chat away at your leisure. Right now I am drawing a... Oh, hello, Bun Bun. Welcome. I am currently drawing a fish monster. I was going to do an original character that I drew years ago, but since it's Halloween and that one was more of a hero type, I figured we need a monster. So I am drawing a mutated anglerfish. Although I'm not entirely sure I'm gonna keep the antenna. I mean, I know anglerfish, that's what they have, but it just kinda makes it look a little goofy. Even by my standards, it looks a little goofy. So how is the Bun Bun today? Hanging in there, hanging in there. One day at a time and all that. Don't think this is going to be quite as horrific as I had planned. Eh, we'll see what the inks tell us.
The inks are the master. We are but the servers.
Hand. Oh dear, Heavenly Father above. I just realized I'm drawing a I'm drawing a mutated anglerfish. And I don't know if you guys have ever watched Ben 10, but one of his alien forms is a humanoid anglerfish. That's terrible. That's terrible. Actually, come to think of it, they had an episode where Gwen got the Omnitrix. Now, in fish biology, male fish are generally 32, sometimes even 90% larger than the females. And in the case of anglerfish, the males more or less amount to what are essentially fish zits compared to female. The ones that you usually see in all the pictures, those are females. So if Gwen would have transformed into Ripjaw, how big would she have been? Something to think about. Maybe she would have been bigger than way big. About this blue pencil lead breaks very, very easily. No matter what I'm trying to do, I'm not going to be happy with this tail. I might just clip it all together. He doesn't really need the tail. Spider-Man little thing here. Some webbing, webbing. Some fin kind of attached to the arm a little bit. I actually kind of like that. Coming together, so she is. And yes, she is a she. Just because, like I said, if it was a male anglerfish, you wouldn't even see him. It's female. Very, very bulky female, but female nonetheless. Because on this art channel, we go by science. I don't know, what do you think? Would this one give you nightmares? LOL, not for me. Not scared of anything. That's good, that's good. But if it's not frightening enough, then I haven't done my job right, which means I'll probably have to redo the drawing. Yeah, if I do, just means I need to come up with something better the next time. I'm about reaching the apex here. Realize this sucker has no gills. Eh, maybe they're under the head. You can't see them because of the way it's, or how big it is. know. What do you guys think? Keep the tail or let it go? No, you guys are allowed to participate in the chat. I ain't gonna yell at you. Any questions, comments? I'm more than happy to chat with you. I think as far as the initial drawing sketch, that's probably about as good as I can get for the time being, so I'm gonna go ahead and start the inks. Ink is good, ink is king, ink makes me happy. kind of do when I start my inking is I always start from the top and work my way down. That way, minimizes smudging and streaking. Especially considering my big bonehead. So, is everybody having a good time? Doing the best I can to try to make it at least a little entertaining. I know watching somebody draw isn't everybody's idea of a good rip-snorting good time. Did everybody die on me? handed some of this ink. One nice thing about the teeth here is I can get away with having these lines a little thicker because I'm going to make the rest of the mouth black anyway. quiet, this is the kind of stuff I really concentrate on. Probably why you don't see too many art streamers. Everybody likes to hear them talk, hear them goof. But if you're an artist, you don't usually talk a whole lot because you're usually concentrating. I don't. Not sure how big of a Star Wars fan you are, Bun Bun, but your comment there kind of reminded me of Empire Strikes Back when Luke finds Yoda. I'm not afraid. You will be. You will be. kind of doing right now is just some basic outline stuff. I'm not doing too much in the detail work yet. Depending on my mood, sometimes I'll jump into some details, like here on the arm. I got a little bit of detail, but I could put more on later. Just kind of feeling out the pose, feeling where the light's gonna be, letting the drawing guide me. To be honest, this is actually coming together pretty well. looks like a monster. I guess the real question is, does it feel like a monster? Excuse me a minute. Had to wet my whistle. Still not sure if I want to put that tail on or not. It looked gaudy. What do you guys think? I guess it's just one of you now. Yeah, we'll put it. on now is just some detail work. about to the home stretch. In case they're not really that visible on camera, what I'm doing is I'm adding some very thin lines to give an indication of scales. I do apologize if my big head is in the way, but like I said, I gotta kinda put a little bit of focus onto this. this just might about do it. Ain't much more I can think of to add to this piece. I think we will call it there. So yeah, I think we'll call it here. Now I just want to thank the one person so far that seems to have stayed to actually watch the whole stream, or at least however long you were here. Please remember to follow me on Instagram at the Unprofessional Artist, or check out my YouTube channel, which is also the Unprofessional Artist. Something for fun. Once again, thank you everybody who managed to stay around or stop in. I will see you next live stream. Take care.